All right, guys, I hope you have seen the video and you want to make your GTA 5 look like that you saw in the video. Of course, everybody wants to have their GTA 5 look such amazing, and it is possible. You can definitely do that, but you have to install mods for it. So here in this video, I'll be showing you how to install the graphics mods as well as the car mods, that is add-on cars and all the traffic mods and realism and everything around Los Santos, which will make it feel like the real California. And provided the graphics mod here is a paid one, that is the Natural Vision Evolved and the LA Revo and the Real California mod. These are paid versions, also the Quant V graphics. Apart from that, the car mods and the reshades are completely free to use, and all the things that I will be showing you in this video, I'll put the download links in the description. So let's just start off, and first things first, you cannot play GTA online with this version, that is you cannot access your GTA online with the modded one. Even if you try, it will show you that you are trying to enter GTA online using altered version of the game. So I recommend you don't do that because you might get banned from GTA online for doing so. So safe thing is always try to mod in offline mode, not in online mode, and I'll be showing you exactly what you need to do to make your GTA look the same way as you saw in the video. And the specs that I am running here is a GTX 1080 Ti and 16 GB of DDR4 RAM, Ryzen 7 2700X, and the GTA is being run on a hard disk instead of an SSD because the modded one will be a very big one in size. So without any delay, let's just start off. So first things first, you will need to download Open4V because Open4 is the software that will allow you to get into your GTA files, because the RPF files are not readable by any software other than Open4. So it is mainly required, and it is the base of the modding. Whenever you mod, you need Open4. So if you guys are familiar with modding, I guess you guys have already downloaded Open4 and set up, but still I'll show you. And for all the mods that I have used here will be available here, except the paid mods. The paid mods are Patreon only. I will also provide the link in the description for you. If you want, you can buy them from Patreon. And without any delay, I'll show you how Open4V works. So you can see, first you will get some options over here. You have to click GTA5, that is Windows, because that's the platform we are using right now. And upon installation, you will see this is my GTA mods folder, and not the mods folder though, it's the GTA installation folder where I have installed GTA, and you can see here is a mods folder. Now let me show you the actual GTA folder where the game is installed. So this is the entire GTA folder, and here is a mods folder which I have created. It is very much important that you make this mods folder, and inside that you have these files which you will get here. You will get update, you will get common, and from x64 you have to select A to I, all of them you got to select, and then L, V, W. These are the basic things that you will need for modding. These are the files that you will be needing for modding right now. So we will copy just all these files. Even if you install some other mods which require some other file, you can just select it from here, right click on copy and go here and paste it. I have already done that, so let's just move on. Now we have the mods folder over here, and here in Open4, the first thing you got to do is go to ASI manager, and you got to install everything, that is ASI loader, Open4V, ASI. These both will allow the Open4V software to make changes to the game, and the game will use the modded version instead of the original vanilla version of the files. And Open4 camera can be also be enabled if you want. It will allow you to have no restrictions in camera boundary in Rockstar Editor when you are making any kind of a video in Rockstar Editor. So it is for that, open camera. You got to install it and close. And there you go, you are set up with Open4V. And for now, let's close Open4 and go to the mods folder that I have here. Now we will be installing all this step by step. I'll be providing the timestamps below so that you can skip to whichever one part you want specifically. So first we will be installing NVE, that is the Natural Vision Evolved, which is the graphics mod which is paid. Then we'll be using LA Revo, which has the real California atmosphere, real traffic, and all the hoardings and everything changed to real world California. Then we'll be installing QuantV, which is another graphics overhaul above NVE, which is compatible with NVE. And then we'll be adding some forest in San Andreas, we'll be adding some pine trees and all. This is the free one. The first three are paid, and the fourth, fifth and sixth are free ones. You can use them and you can carry on. But before that, you need to install certain requisites, that is certain files in your GTA 5 folder, which are here. This will include your script hook, which you guys, if you are already modded, you must be knowing what is script hook, the DLL files and the script hook.net. And you will be needing a trainer, which you will use to spawn your cars or access any of your mods in the game, that is the trainer V. And also you will be using a native trainer. These are all the trainer tools and accessories that you will need in game to access the mods that you have installed. So what you got to do is, I'll provide all the links in the description as a separate requisites folder, and from there you can download each file. They all will come in this shape. You got to copy all of them. You got to your GTA 5 folder. GTA 5. So here you got to do this. You got to paste it over here. Now I had certain files, so I had replaced them again. Now there's this game config file. I'll be showing you why you need that game config file. It will not be installed here, but that's not a problem. You can still put it here, but it will be needed in the end. Like I'll be showing you a error scenario. Most of the time an error occurs due to this game config, which can be fixed easily, so no need to panic for that. Now since we are all set up with the installation of mods and all, OpenFOV all set up, let's start the modding. Now first thing we need to do is we will be installing NVE single player package, that is the offline mode. Now here you will be having a Natural Vision installer, that is an OIV file which is compatible with OpenFOV, which we'll be installing through this. And then you got some other required files which we'll be using. So first step is to go to your package installer. You got to browse to your NVE location where you have downloaded the NVE package, and inside that you have this Natural Vision installer. You open it. You click on install, and always install in mods folder, never install in game folder. That is the reason why we created the mods folder and added the game files to it, just in case your game crashes. So if you have installed it in mods folder, you can just simply delete it and you can run the vanilla version of the game, which will be accessible to the game folder. But if you install it in game folder and the game crashes due to certain mod, any of the mods if crashes and it makes the game unstable, then you have to reinstall the game, which is a very tedious process. So always install in mods folder. You got to put it in mods folder. We have to confirm installation. It will take certain time, but it will be installed. But you can also install it manually, but I don't recommend doing that, because that's a complex process and you may miss out on certain files which will cause problem while playing the game. The mod will not install properly, so it is always advised, if it has a OIV file, just install it automatically instead of the manual way. So it will take certain time, and this is a paid mod. I'll put the link in the description. Raged is the person who creates this mod. You can go to his Patreon, subscribe to his Patreon and get this mod. And similarly, LA Revo and QuantV, those are also there. You can just purchase them like from Patreon membership or subscription. So you can see the installation has succeeded. So we will close this and let's go back to GTA folder. Now you see our Natural Vision is installed. Now we have to install the main files, which is this one, these three files inside the main folder. You copy it. You go to your GTA 5 folder where you have installed your GTA 5, and just paste it right in the folder, Grand Theft Auto folder. So it has replaced, it has done it. So we'll go back again to mods folder and we will be installing ENB. So this inside ENB is basically your graphics enhancement tool which will just improve your vision, your display of the game, like the objects will be sharper and reflections would be there. So for that, it completely depends on you whether you want the high settings, medium settings or low settings, because everybody has different systems. So with my 1080 Ti, I can go to ultra settings. So let me just copy it. And again, we got to go to our installation folder where we have installed GTA, and we will paste it. So you see, it has got pasted over here. Now we are done with Natural Vision installer. Now if you have a higher end graphics card like a 1080 Ti, which I am using right now, you can use the optional add-ons as well. And if you have a lower end graphics card and you are getting performance lag, like the performance is very low, you can just install this performance boost. Now what it will do is it will lower down lights at certain points during night time and draw distance to make your game run at higher FPS, somewhat higher FPS comparatively than it used to go. So this is a very good thing for those who are running on a low spec and you want to get the best performance out of it. So we have installed performance boost. Now we will also be using a lot of add-ons, I'll show you. You can also increase enhanced motion blur. You can install this one. I'm going with high intensity. So guys, here whatever mod I am using, you guys have seen the exact same mod in the starting of this video. The gameplay you saw, I created the exact same mods the same way. So if you are following all these steps, the entire process from graphics mode to add-on cars, and if you are running a very good system, then you will get the similar performance like I was getting and similar gameplay experience like that shown in the video. So you see, enhanced motion blur is also installed. Let's go again. And this one is very important. If you are installing NVE, then you need to install decrease vanilla streetlight intensity, because most of the time when you install Natural Vision and you go to the game and you set to night mode, when you turn when you change time to night, the street lights will flash and the radius of that light will be long enough, like it will be very irritating for you to play the game, like so much brightness throughout everywhere during night time. So you got to decrease the vanilla street light intensity. This will decrease the vanilla street light intensity, keeping the Natural Vision light intensity as it is. And everything goes inside the mods folder. Never install anything in games folder, except you got to only install Iron Man scripts and everything in the game folder. Apart from that, you don't have to install anything in the games folder. Now again, I'll be installing another optional add-on. This is the new street light, that is the NVE street light. This is another mod which will add custom street light colors to the game. Everything you have to install in the mods folder itself. Now if you want, you have the timestamps in the video, you can skip to wherever you want. And if you got any problem, you can just comment me in this video. I'll be active and I'll be replying and helping as many as I can. So what my idea is to make sure, if I'm getting the same experience, why not everybody? Because a lot of my friends, I started making the video and they told me to make a video on how to mod this installation, because it's a little tricky one. But those of you who have been modding in Open4V will have a very good idea about how to mod. So now we are in the trash modifier. This is another optional add-on. What this will do is add more trash throughout the game. Like you guys have seen in NFS, the cars are there with a little trash in front of them, in some street, in front of some street. So this makes the game look more realistic and more realistic atmosphere, you can say. So we will be installing this one as well. You got to install. So it will take some time, and yeah, it has installed. And looks like we have installed most of our optional add-ons. We won't be, and here is the Natural Vision uninstaller as well. if you feel like your game is crashing or any problem is there which you can't find the solution to, and you are seeing that the natural vision is causing some error to the game, you can just click on this natural vision uninstaller. It's also an OIV package file which will uninstall all the optional add-ons as well as the NVE package from your game, making it run on a vanilla settings completely fine. So we have completed installing Natural Vision Evolved. First stage is done. Next thing we got to install is LA Revo. Now LA Revo is a set of four files, that is RCA, that is Real California Atmosphere. What this will do is add custom real life hoardings and McDonald's banners, posters, and the burger shots will be turned into McDonald's and KFCs and all these things. So real atmosphere of California you will get. And in LA Revo you will get more trees throughout Los Santos, giving it a little of more Los Angeles kind of feel. And with the real traffic you will be getting the entire overhaul of AI vehicles in GTA. Like most of the vehicles in GTA will be converted to real life cars, like Hummer and Chevy. More than 50 to 100 original cars will be replacing the generic GTA cars. And the last one is heap adjuster, which we have already installed as a requisite, so we don't need to install that. So let's just go with RCA. Now here you see that is the RCA file you will get. The link will be in the description, all mods. So RCA, you will see it's a DLC RPF, okay. So what you got to do is open 4V, go to mods folder, go to update, x64, DLC packs. Here you can see all the DLC pack folders are there. Here everything is of the file type DLC RPF. So when you see a mod that has DLC RPF in it, you got to drag that folder, and before dragging it you got to turn on the edit mode. I'm sorry. So you got to drag this folder inside here. You see the RCA is added here. So now for this mod to work within the game, for the game to detect this mod, you got to do one more change. You got to go mods, update RPF, you got to go to common data, and here you have a DLC list. This consists all of the DLC that are installed in that folder. Just click on edit, go to the bottom, you can copy this last line, whatever the line is, you can just copy it for the syntax. You paste it, and this part is the one you need to change. You just backspace it, and you gonna put the name that is exactly the same name as that of the folder. So you got to click save. You see here it is RCA. So here we have put the name RCA over here. So you can see. So exact same name should be there, otherwise the game won't detect it and it won't spawn in game. And that's how RCA is installed. Now you got to install LA Revo. LA Revo and real traffic consists of OIV file, so that is automatic installation. RCA was the manual installation which I was talking to you about, dragging the folders everywhere. So we again go to package installer, we go to LA Revo. So these are five parts, you need to install them individually. It will take some time, but because it's a very big mod, and everything, as I said, will be going to the mods folder, nowhere else. You have to put everything in the mods folder. So after installing this mods, like I was using Natural Vision Remastered. If you guys haven't installed, if you guys don't want to purchase Natural Vision Evolved, there's a free version of it which is called the Natural Vision Remastered, which came back in 2017. But I guess that's the outdated one and it is no longer available, I guess. But I'll try to find out certain links if it is available anywhere, and if I get one, I'll be putting the link in the description. You can download it. And that's the free version, and that too is also really good graphics overhaul. I have made a video on Natural Vision Remastered as well. The link will be in the description. You can check that out as well. So you see the LA Revo part 1 has been installed. We will go again to package installer, opening, and we'll click install, mods folder. So you can see, you can get all the information about the game over here. So this will change the whole look of Los Santos into Los Angeles. And I really was very much satisfied after installing these mods that GTA can look so good. GTA 5, which has been here for around 6 years on PC, that can look so good. Like the difference between the vanilla GTA and the mod GTA are completely like, there's a big difference between both of them. The modded one is phenomenal. Like I even find it equivalent to some of the Need for Speed games and Forza games with the ENB and reshared on, because the graphics are so good with motion blur turned on. So it's really good. So you can see we have installed part 2 as well. Now we gotta install the third part. So it is a little time taking process. It will take you some time, but it's worth it. The total installation will be around within half an hour or so if you want, because the exact mod that I have been using. And also I'll also be making video on how to install the Iron Man mod, Spider-Man mod, Thor, Hulk, Thanos with power, obviously, and that are also paid versions. You can try the trial version, but it will be a trial version of 1 day or so. So I'll be making another different video on that, and adding custom pets and bodyguards. So I'll be making a video on that. Get subscribed to the channel if you want to see more of such tutorial videos and gameplay. I mainly make gameplay videos, and I only make tutorials of GTA 5 installation, because this is the complex part where people get confused easily. Like I also got confused the first time I was installing this. I have been installing this I guess since 4 times since last 3 to 4 days, because every day I'm adding some certain other mods which is causing the game to crash. So I am reinstalling it and all that. So once you get the hold of modding in OpenFour, you will get the idea about how to do things and how not to. So it's not much of a confusing thing. It just needs some time to get familiar with. So that's the Elder Evo 4th part we'll be installing now, and it's done. And now remains the 5th part, which is the last one. And it will install much more quickly because it's a smaller file size. That's just an extension. And then we'll be coming to real California traffic, which will add custom cars to the games. For example, Franklin's car Buffalo will be replaced with the Dodge Charger SRT, and the normal Buffalo will be replaced with, I guess, a normal Charger. And there is Dodge Demon, Camaro SS, a lot more cars. So it's really fun. So you can see the LR Evo part is done. So now we will be going to real traffic, where we will be installing these 3 OIV files. So we will be going to Tools, Package Installer, GTA 5 Mods, Real Traffic. So we will be installing this in the Mods folder. Everything goes inside the Mods folder. And those that will require you to go to the Games folder will not have the option to select the Mods folder. There will be only the Games folder. And the description will be also given that this file will be installed in the Games folder, because it's a script, because most of the scripts are only installed in the Games folder. Every other mod, every paid mod, car, graphics overhaul mod, map mod, everything is to be installed inside the Mods folder, because if you install it in the Mains folder and it crashes the game, then you have to reinstall the whole game, which is a very tedious job. So you see the first part has been installed. We'll be installing the second part as well. To install Mods folder, installation. So this is another extension of Elder Evo itself, but it will add the custom cars. That is why it is of around 2 to 3 GB in size. It will replace all of the cars in the game with some or the other car. Provided the DLC cars, like the Casino Heist update or any other car that comes up, has not been replaced, because this LA Revo and Real Traffic was made way back in 2020, and the Casino and all update came in the second quarter or third quarter of 2020. So those cars are not replaced. Those cars will be there. You can play using those cars as well. The other cars which were in the vanilla version of the game are replaced, and it's a very good experience to see. It's completely California atmosphere in the game. And I always recommend you to check the graphics settings, and whenever you are installing any of the mod, each of the mod comes with a description folder and a readme folder. Do read that, guys, because it's always helpful to install through that process, because you can easily see the video and install, but reading the file and understanding will give you much more idea about how to install and how to make sure that your game does not crash. And it also has some frequently asked questions as well in the bottom section of the readme file. You can check that out as well if you have any doubt. So you see, the real traffic mod has also been installed, and now we will be going back to our LA-Revo folder. As I said, the fourth file which is there, heap adjuster, you need not install that. That's not required at all. And then you have here the recommended settings. So since I use an 11 GB graphics card, so I can play easily on this settings. However, I still don't play on 4K, because 4K at such graphics will give you heavy performance drop. So I play at 1080p, which gives me around 40 FPS on such high settings as well. So that's a good one. So now the LA-Revo is installed, and now we'll be installing Quant V. This is the last paid mod that I'll be installing over here, provided all these three mods are paid one. After this, the mods that you want to install will be free one. So, and the best thing is, none of these mods are interconnected with each other. However, you shall not install Quant V if you don't have Natural Vision involved installed. And LA-Revo is independent of everything, and all this Forest of San Andreas add-on cars, these all are independent of each other. They don't require much of any they don't depend upon the other mods. And the reset installation is for the ENB that we installed over here. The reset will be installed after I install both this. So now let's install Quant V. It's a graphics overhaul mod, and simply go to again package installer, GTA 5, Quant V. You have to open it, and you have to install it in the mods folder. It will again install over in the mods folder. And this is a Patreon beta. All of these graphics mods are still work in progress, and if you purchase or take membership from Patreon and buy them, they will be giving you updates as well. Further updates of work they will be giving you for free to download. So that's a good thing. It's a one-time investment you can do, and you can just enjoy the updates after that as well. So that's a good thing. So the installation is complete for Quant V, and now we have the optional folder here, which has performance and quality presets, which has all these settings you can install based on your system specification. Low to hyper you can install. I'll be installing hyper, and we won't be installing any of these things here except the two things, that is Corona in vehicles and not the virus. It's the reflection of other images on the car body, and long draw distance. We will be installing both these because of my setup, because of my configuration, it is quite good for installing such things. Now, provided if you are using any low spec graphics card, I don't recommend you installing these optional things. You can just simply go with Quant V. So let's go to optionals and first install the hyper version. Now it is installing. So what it will do is add some files to the ENB folder that we copied to the game, and the other folder inside the game, in mods folder, it will add some folders. Now that's done. Let's again go to package installer, go to optional, enable Corona. I'm not enabling the coronavirus, I'm just enabling the Corona reflection feature of the game. Don't get me wrong over there. So you can see that's installing right now. That has installed. These are quite small packages, it will install within no time. And this is longer draw distance. It will make your performance drop. So always be sure that you have the proper specification of your system to match such to be able to run such mods. Now we have also installed the optional folders files as well. Now we are complete with the first three. The first half is complete. Now we are going to the second half, and now we'll be adding Forests of San Andreas. And here I don't recommend you adding any optional maps, but if you want, you can definitely do that, and you can check for how to install them in the readme. But for now, we'll be only adding the trees. The trees will somehow look like this. This is what the trees will look like, and these are of two variants, three variants actually. You can see cedar, redwood, and mixed wood. So what mixed is, it is a combination of cedar and redwood, and it has more redwood towards the Fort Zancudo side. So I definitely always go with the mixed one, and just go with the RRC one. It has CR1 has more trees down the south of the forest, while RRC has more redwood trees than the at the south of the forest when it is a mixed one. So you can see the forest folder, it's a DLC RPF. So again, you know what to do. You go to forest, you go to open four, go to mods, update, x64, DLC pack, and just click on edit mode here. Drag these files into the folder. You see this forest added here. Last time we added RCA. So since we added a DLC RPF file, for the game to recognize that file, we'll be needing to make sure to add it in the DLC list. For that, we go to update.rpf, common, data. Here we have the DLC list. You need to click on it. We click edit. Again, we go down, copy the last code, and here we need to make the change. We will cut this one out, and we will write exactly the same name as that, the forest. Forest, we have it. We click on save. We go back. So that's how your Forest of San Andreas mod is installed now. And for this mod to run, the maker of this mod, who has made this mod, has specified a game config file. Now here comes the game config file which we needed, which I said we would be needing. And we need to go to our GTA 5 folder, open in a new window, games. So we have a game config file over here, which I also have in the requisites folder. Now what you need to do is, the requisites which I told you, here is the game config. Open your open 4, go to mods, update RPF, common, data, and you see there's a game config here. You have to replace it with that file. So it will replace your game config file. So now your Forest of San Andreas mod has been installed. It can run on the game. So now we will be going to reset installation. The reset setup link will be in the description below. You can check that out. You have to set up reshed, which will so you see, upon using reshed, it will have to ask you which application you want to install reshed for. Just click on browse, go to your folder where you have installed your GTA 5, and click on GTA 5, the application, and open it. And then you got to check all, everything is checked. You have to install OK, and it will install it automatically. It is installing now. It will take some time.
A few moments later.
So as you see guys, our reset setup is successful, and we can close this window now. One more thing guys, when you are installing a reshed, you need to install certain presets so that you get the exact same settings and same visuals as that you saw in the video. So for that, you need to go to Inter's Patreon page. I'll be providing the link in the description, and you will get all the presets for Inter over there. You can get all these cinematic presets. Now once you download them, what you need to do is copy them. Click on copy, go to your folder where your GTA 5 is installed, go to ENB series, and you need to add your files over here. Now how you will access these files, I will show you in game after the mods are all installed and complete. So our reset setup is successful now, and we can move on to the last part, which is add-on cars. Now add-on cars is simply just adding like the DLC folders which we added to the game. So for example, I have two mods here, like two car mods, which is Mazda RX-7 and the new Toyota Supra A90, and we'll be adding them. So it's a RAR WinZip file. So you see there's RAR file here, we need to first extract it over here, and this one as well, need to extract it. Now you see both of them have extracted, and we need to close this up. So you see after after extracting both the folders over here, we'll be clicking on them. We have the Mazda RX-7. SP means single player, while 5M means the role playing server mod, which you can use this mod in. So we'll go to single player, and we have this folder called RX7FDBN, that is the version number, I guess, version of the mod, and this is the DLC RPF there. So we'll go to open 4, we'll go to mods, update, X64, DLC pack, and here we're going to drag this. So you see it's added here. Now the same we are going to do with Toyota Supra A90. So it, you can see that's the DLC RPF over here. We'll just drag it to here. So you see both of them are added over here. So what we need to do now is we need to go to again mods, update RPF, common data, and we need to edit the DLC list that came with it. We copy the last line, we paste it, the name RX7FDBN. The folder name, the name here should be the exact as that of the folder name, as in the DLC RPF. We again add A90SH, that is the folder name, you can see over here. It's done. Click on save, and that's it. That's the all thing you need to run the GTA 5 the way you want it to be. Alright guys, with that said, everything has been installed and we will be getting into the game soon now. So you can see now here it's a Quant V instead of GTA 5 logo in the loading screen. That's because of the Quant V graphics that we have installed. Also the loading California world because of the real California atmosphere mod RCA that we have installed. So these are the some changes that come with the mod. And while since we have installed ENB and the reshade, so we can access reshade using shift and enter. So you see all the reshades are available here. I don't recommend you changing anything in the reshade. However, you can apply your favorite presets if you download them, just like I did from Inter. Like these are Patreon only presets. You can purchase them via membership. Just simply click home and you are in your ENB menu. And here I already have selected Intel preset for reshade. So I can also, here is the location you have to choose. So here is the location where I installed it. So Intel Inter preset for reshade, I select it. And you see that is the game after the graphics mod has been installed. So since I am running everything high, I am getting some mid 30 FPS around. So that is how the game looks now. I will be showing you various times and atmosphere in which the game looks like, the graphics, how it looks. So first, we need to access our mods. Now, we have installed a file called trainerv.asi in our main GTA folder from the requisite that I was telling you about. So simply click F3 and just press F3 and you get into the menu which comes with option, vehicle option, everything is there. Simply go to vehicle spawning and just below there you have your added vehicles menu, in which the vehicles that you add in your DLC pack folder, the DLC RPF mods, will be shown here. You see there are all the GT Online vehicles and planes that were added are shown here, and at the bottom you see that's an A90SH and an RX-7. So if we click on it, we get spawned into an RX-7. So that's how it looks. Oh my god, I spawned at the wrong place, I guess. So we will be going now. I will show you now. You can change your weather, your time. Let's just set the time to noon. Okay, I guess the weather is neutral, I guess. Let's do it neutral. Okay, so here it is neutral weather, and your game will look somehow like this. That's in clear and that's extra sunny. Now, I did, while taking photographs and screenshots, I use a PNB feature. When I click home, you will see. Here you can simply search for one thing called SSR, which is the screen space reflection. If you click on it, you see everything goes reflective, like everything is reflected down there. If you click on it, it again goes. So it is good for when you are taking in-game screenshots. So the reflections are real good. This won't affect much of your performance. And let me just remove the HUD so that you can get the good experience. You see, here it is showing, you can easily see the graphics has changed phenomenal. Like, for example, I'll just show up here the actual graphics. I'll show you, like, now you can check the actual graphics of the game. Now is the graphics here, so you see there's a phenomenal change actually. And of course these are mods, so your game will crash at certain point, like now it did. So it will crash, that's inevitable, because these are mods and these are not installed properly. So these are not finished by Rockstar Games, so this will crash. Since it's mod, it will crash. And I will put some other gameplay videos now for you to see how the graphics works and how this graphics mod and all these mods help in improving the game.
Now you got stuck. Nice whip.
So I hope you guys have enjoyed the video and you guys got to know about how to install in this mod. And if you have any doubt, just type them in the comments below and I will answer to as many as I can. And with this tutorial, you can, if you follow from the beginning to end, you will get a complete overhaul and makeover of your existing GTA game, provided you need to have a decent GPU for that. I would recommend something above GTX 1060 for such graphics, because otherwise your game will run at 10 to 15 FPS, which is not doable at all. So for those who are having above 1060-ish graphics card, you can easily run this game. And I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Do let me know your doubts in the comment below, and if you liked the video, hit like and get subscribed. I make such GTA videos very regular, and I stream every day from Monday to Friday on YouTube, so you can join me there as well. So till then, good luck, have fun, peace.